You have absolutely no idea when Duke and Angel are getting back from New York.
Cross my heart, I do not know. I'll have Duke call as soon as he gets in.
Well, if he gets in touch with you, you have him call me here at the office.
Just a second. Here's Angel. Maybe Duke's with him. Angel, telephone. It's Anna Lafer.
I'm not here.
I already told her.
Hi, Anna. How are you?
I'm fine. Is Duke with you?
No, he's not. He got hung up on business, and he's going to take a later flight.
Well, they go every hour. Is he going to be on the next one?
Gee, I really don't know.
You were with him, weren't you?
Yes, I was, but I only saw him part of the time.
What exactly is it that he's doing there?
Restaurant business. I don't know all the details.
Is Duke all right, Angel? Is he really all right?
Anna, the boss is a very important part of my life, and yours, lady.
If there was something screwy going on, believe me, I would tell you.
Yeah, well, I hope so. I told Bill, and I want you to know as well, if he gets in touch with you, you have him call me here immediately.
Absolutely will do.
Thank you.
I had a seat.
He's been waiting for you. It's good to see you, Duke. It's good of you to come.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for everything you did, man.
You should probably save your thanks, you know. It's still a bloody mess. Where's Victor, please?
He was the golden boy, Julian, the day he was born. Always a laugh, a smile. So smart. Everybody saw it right away. He knew when he was 15. He said to me, "Father, we got to get out of the cops and robber business. It's a game. It's over."
He was right. Victor, I know it's difficult for you, but you have to come out of your grief and listen to me very carefully.
I'm here.
I talked to God.
He wants a war.
No, he doesn't. I convinced him he had too much to lose. He's happy with his shares and his territories.
You got that from Carter?
I did.
That's what Julian wanted. That's just what he would have done. It's like a gift to honor my son.
So it's over. There'll be no war. There'll be peace. And I want to go home. I'm going home to my wife. Won't you listen to me, Victor? This is the end for me. I don't want to be mixed up with the mob ever again. Never.
No, Duke. You can't get out. Not now, not ever.
Julian died in a trap that was set for you.
I know that.
He wasn't even supposed to be there. If it hadn't been for him, the next time you saw your wife, you'd be looking up at her out of a pine box.
Oh, Victor, you think I don't know that as well? I was close to Julian. I owed him already. If it hadn't been for him, I never would have found Anna when she was kidnapped. Julian and I, we were close friends.
I could see that. Your obligations didn't end when Julian died. They multiplied.
I would give anything for Julian to be alive today. I honor his memory. I have to respect it. I didn't kill him. I didn't set him up.
You played a part in it.
I wish you understand, Victor. This could turn my whole life upside down. I could lose my wife because of this.
If she's a good wife, you can turn her around.
Oh, not to the life of living with a mob. Never. I could never do that.
Duke, I have to change the dressing on Victor's wound. He needs a rest from the pain. I'm going to give him a shot.
All right, Victor. I'm going home to Port Charles now.
You can't go until we come to an understanding.
Would you give me a minute, please, while I straighten something out? Do you mind? I'm not going to change my mind. We can talk for a year, but I will not change my mind.
I have to do this now. I'm sorry. He's not going to admit it, but he's in a lot of pain.
Will the short knock him out? I can eat all later.
Well, he'll sleep for a short time. Come on, let's walk away into the other room. Come on.
Duke, you be here when I wake up. We're talking about your honor. We're talking about respect for the dead. That he shall not have died in vain.
Calm down, Victor. Come on, into the other room. Come on.
I don't believe Angel. He is a terrible liar.
No. Maybe he's telling the truth. Maybe he did go to the fights. Maybe Duke's not telling him anything.
I know. He's hiding something. But I don't know what he would be covering up for Duke.
Didn't Duke tell you what he was doing?
Yes. He said he had a friend whose restaurant business had gone under, and he was helping put it back on his feet. I mean, I can believe that, because Duke's a very good businessman.
Well, maybe the restaurant owner doesn't even know Angel, and he doesn't want him involved.
Yeah, maybe. Then why would he say he was coming back today and not turn up?
He's probably on the next shuttle back from New York.
Yeah, probably.
So why are you so worried?
Because I feel like I don't know what's going on. You know what we're on the edge of here?
The desk.
I'd have paid you not to say that. What we are on the edge of here is a bureau session to get some clues to a case.
Mm-hmm. You can also use it to help find your lost car keys, like where you are, who you're with, what you're wearing, stuff like that.
Yeah. I sometimes forget that innocent things do happen in this world. The next time you have a case, don't you forget that.
Speaking of cases...
Oh, right. Okay, we've got to do the Fort Charles National Bank today. How many of the signatures have we got analyzed now?
Over half.
Oh, that's good. Well, let's get down to it. I've got these four out. They were out of country.
I think I'm going to spread these in and make them easier. All right.
These four right here.
Brock, knock, knock.
Hello?
You ladies look quite busy this close to tea time.
We didn't realize it was tea time, and yes, we are busy.
I'm kind of curious as to what's happened to your husband and why he isn't upholding his part of the security load.
My husband is doing exactly what he should be doing, and that is taking care of family business. You're the one that assigned him the security load, whatever that might mean.
Look, I don't have an infinite police force. I can't be in many places at once, and as you don't give a damn about your own safety, I mean, judging by the way I just walk in the door.
Oh, well, we women can't be left alone without a big, strong man to protect us.
I just have this gut feeling, and it's so strong that I don't mind making a nuisance out of myself.
Well, you're right, you are being a nuisance. And there is something wrong with your head.
Ah, look, let's not play that old number. Well, Robert's in love with me and just wants to protect.
Oh,
I mean, you're flattering yourself.
No, I'm not. If it isn't me, it's Robin. You're obsessed with us.
Oh, and now we're a psychiatrist. You know, you'll do anything but admit to yourself that you need a 24-hour witness.
I do not. I'm an agent and a cop. I can take perfectly good help of...
Really?
Will you stop arguing, please? Oh, the police should just stay out of this.
Please,
you?
This is
between
a family
us.
Matter, all right?
Well, if you keep arguing...
Who needs it? When you're done, let me know. I'll come back.
Sorry. I didn't mean
for
that.
Yeah, we didn't know.
We would just stop arguing and listen to each other and stop it.
Okay, all right. I apologize, Anna. I was wrong.
You were wrong.
You didn't have to agree.
Well, we've got work to do.
Oh, look, I can't get out of here quick enough.
I need you out of my office.
Good, I'm going.
Tremaine Donnelly.
Look, I'm going. Look, I'm running.
Chief Lewis? Hold on. Guy Lewis.
Yeah, Guy, what is it? Well, I know that. Look, it's your case. Do what you like with it. You don't need my advice. You're a big boy. Next, I'm going to get him a nanny as well.
It's because you're being a nanny to us that your police work is suffering.
You know what the bottom line of this is? I had this very strong feeling that my next big case is going to be your old man.
I've had enough of your suspicions. Duke is a decent man, and I will not have him maligned. Now get out of my office,
you know,
now.
For once, just once, I hope you're right. Now, be a good girl and lock the door after me.
Where were we? Oh, boy. I don't think that our forger is amongst this lot here, and I can't look at another name. My eyes are giving out. I'm going to call it a night.
Me too. How many more bank employee signatures do we have?
Another 40 or so. We've got all the top executives to do yet. It'd be interesting if it's one of them, wouldn't it?
Really?
Would you file that? Okay. I want to... Who is it?
It's the old nanny Scott. Happy
hand. I don't believe it. I do not...
Can you please make me up a file?
Yeah. I want to take these checks there. What do you want?
I dropped in to apologize for stomping around here earlier.
Yeah. All right. Apology accepted.
I mean, I only do it because I want to keep the people I care about safe, including your nerdy husband with all his parent.
All right.
Well, look, just tell me when he gets home so that I can stop fretting.
Of course I will. I'll be fretting if he doesn't turn up soon. I'll call you. You'll be first on my list.
You know, you can call this the old Sherlock at work, but either this place is grossly underheated or you're about to leave.
We're about to leave.
Aha! Well, it's just a coincidence that I lobbed in here.
My goodness, yes.
But since I'm here, why don't I see you safely home, eh?
No. I'm going to the market and I'm going to the cleaners and I'm going to the pharmacy.
Well, I love the market. I love the cleaners.
No.
I can understand that.
Right. I have a license to carry a gun, Robert.
But you see, having a license is one thing.
Robert, please. Seriously.
Huh?
You have to find some kind of harness on this anxiety you have about protecting you because it is straining our relationship beyond belief. I'm finding it very difficult to be your friend. Good night. Good night, Felicia.
Good night.
Do I seem obsessed to you?
Oh, don't involve me. I tried to help you earlier and you both nearly bit my head off.
Oh, listen. I have a way to make up for that, to the prettiest, most desirable girl in town, if you'll let me.
Flowers and flattery will get you everywhere.
How's about a spot of food somewhere?
I'm not hungry.
The old Scorpio charm isn't working too well at the moment. Thinks.
No, it's not that. It's just that I've been here all day. I had a late lunch.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to go to a movie and then have some soup.
Well, you know, movies have always worked in the past. Spot of the old black and white tends to bring out the true side of one's character. Going alone?
Uh-huh. You can join me if you like.
Fantastic. Maybe we'll get a bite to eat after.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm full of don't want us tonight. It's just the idea of sitting in a restaurant with all those people sounds absolutely horrible.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice out. Why don't we go for a picnic after the movie? Get some food.
If that's what you want.
Yeah, sounds great. It's really not that cute. It was warm, you know, it was about 60 degrees.
Really?
Thanks.
Could you pass me the telephone again, please?
Yes, Mr. Lavery.
Duke, Victor's awake again. He's asking for you.
Okay, I'll be right there.
I wanted to talk to you for a second away from him. You know, his wound isn't that severe. He'll be bouncing back in no time. I'm concerned about the deeper wound inside.
His grief, yes.
Exactly. We have to make it as easy as we can for him.
Okay, I'll bear that in mind. I just want to call my wife and tell her what time to expect me home, and I'll be upstairs.
Good, I'll tell her.
Of course, Mr. Hardy, we've been expecting you right this way.
Thank you very much.
Here's your table, sir.
Simone, was that... Excuse me, was that Duke Lavery over there? I'm afraid I don't know a Mr. Lavery, sir. Which gentleman is it? But he's gone. I must have been mistaken. This is a very nice table. Thank you very much.
So, what was that about Duke Lavery?
Well, nothing. Someone who looks like him.
Oh.
Promise me something.
I think I know what it is already. You'd like us to forget what my mother had said. It's okay. It's fine by me.
Thank you.
I mean, I know that there's nothing we can do about it anyway.
Thank you very much. You know, it's nice to see that in a changing world, things don't change that much, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I think the same waitresses work here the menu looks the same.
Ah, but I'm sure the prices have changed. And to think we came on intern salaries. How do you ever do it?
I have no idea. Although the only thing I remember about being an intern is the maitre d', however, he can't remember us from one time to the next.
Well, no, he makes it his business to just remember those gentlemen with the shoulder holsters under their jackets.
Oh, you bet. When Victor Jerome walks in this place, I bet he gets to his knees and he bows. Remember how they used to strut in here like Roman legionaries, thinking they ruled the world?
You can give you the creeps. But it is kind of exciting to think that at that table over there, the underworld is being ruled.
I wonder what he's doing tonight.
Don't even think about it. Do you know the shooting that they had on the news? The police are saying that it could be a gang war.
You know, that wasn't very, very far from here.
As long as it's not here. What did I say? The mobsters tend to rub each other out in restaurants?
They usually end up shooting each other. The most...
I've worked very hard, Victor, to turn my life around, you know. It hasn't been easy. I've battled every step of the way, but it's been worth it. I have a business, a good business that's legitimate. I have a good line of credit at the bank. I have a wonderful family. I've got a wife that I love more than life itself. And a child who's... Well, she's so beautiful, it just stirs your heart to look at her.
Nobody's going to take those things away from you. We're going to add to them.
Oh, damn it, Victor. That is not the way this works. You know that. I'm sorry Julian is dead. I truly am. I mourn him also. I wish I could have stopped the bullets that killed him. But just because he is dead does not mean I'm obligated to you for the rest of my life.
You finished?
Yes.
These guys here, I notice they treat you with a lot of respect all of a sudden. Where do you think that comes from?
Probably an order from you.
I didn't say a word. These are hard men. Respect is not something you do an order from them, like a takeout pizza. You earned it. You killed Carruthers.
Oh, come on, that was an accident. We've already established that.
No one has a gun in his hand by accident. You stood off the men who were trying to hijack my truck. You got rid of their bodies when they turned up stiff. You didn't ask what to do. You did it. You went to meet with Julian. It was a trap. You took out two men. Two men with very good reputations. Duke, if you're not one of us, what the hell are you?
I don't want to live this life. I cannot do it. I don't want to live like this. I feel as if I'm in quicksand.
What you learn about respect, the kind of respect these men now give you, is that you never have to stop earning it. You're in, and the only way out is the way Julian just took.
Victor, I've always taken great pride in meeting my obligations. My honor means as much to me as yours does to you.
We wouldn't be talking if I didn't know that. I know you've got painful choices to make, but you have to make them.
I promised Julian that I would do what I could. I'm going to keep my promise.
Duke, I need you. Very badly. I was counting on Julian. Now, I'll count on you.
Yeah, but you can count on me also to oppose you when you're wrong.
Different opinions leading to the same goal are healthy.
There is one condition I'm going to insist upon.
Name it.
I'll do what Julian wanted. I will fulfill his dreams. You listen to me. I'm going to move our assets into legitimate businesses. Legitimate. Where we have clean businesses. The linen trade, trucking, garbage disposal, all traditional mob businesses. We stop putting the muscle on people, do you understand?
If we keep our share and make our profits, no problem. But it's not like a light switch. You can't just shut some businesses down. People depend upon them for a living. Very dangerous people.
I know that. I'm not about to try to change human nature. If they don't like it, they go their way. We just simply move out the business.
We get our money out.
Oh, yeah. We get our money out. Are you satisfied? I'm going home. I'm going to see my family.
We got a lot to do. Be back before the end of the week.
It's not going to be easy, you know. I have a wife who's very intelligent. She's also very strong-willed. She wants to know why I'm up here in New York City so often. How many restaurant suppliers is there here for me to see?
We need a better story. What did you tell her for this time?
I told her there was a friend who was a business that was in trouble, and a restaurant. I came up here to see what I could do.
That's a good story. Maybe troubles continue. Maybe this friend offers you a position in exchange for your effort, something like that. A reason why you have to stay away from home more often.
Yeah, I hope it works.
I know this is hard for you now, but you'll thank me in time. There are very big rewards in all of this, you'll see. We have fine people in this organization. They respect you. They give you 150%.
You don't think we're rushing season a little by trying to picnic in the park, do you?
No, not a bit. Got up to 50 degrees today, you know.
Well, now that it was 100 years ago today that we had the biggest blizzard in history. Right at this very spot.
So what do you want to do? You want to eat here or not?
Well, if you're cold, we could go inside.
Well, come on, we're sturdier than that. Let's just pretend like it's spring.
Right.
It's barely below freezing.
Right. Right. Shout out.
Righto. Mm. Tell me, why is it that people laugh in movies whenever people get pies in their faces? It's kind of stupid, but I laugh and I have a stomachache from it.
Well.
Hey, what's this?
Mm. These chips will give you a stomachache, too. It's just that when we see someone get a pie in the face, it reminds us that things could be a whole lot worse. Well, that could be a reason.
Robert.
Mm-hmm.
I want to thank you for being there when I was feeling low.
It's a two-way street, love. As I recall, the last time we did the movies, you just received that non-letter from Prisco.
And you just received that forward letter from Holly.
Yeah. You know, makes me think maybe we should stop meeting like this. People will start to talk.
Well, they were not.
Gossip.
Thank you. Well, I don't care what you say. I think it's going to be an early spring.
Hmm. Yep. I think the cabin fever is going to be at a pretty high rate.
Hey,
very.
Hey, you guys, go somewhere else, will you?
At least they're not shooting at one another.
Think it's safer, should we run in the hills?
Hmm. Mm. Mess up here.
Mm. Didn't you ever litter when you were younger?
Yeah, but never paper. Body or two.
Oh, you spy.
Yeah.
Spy.
That's us.
Here, have some hot coffee. Mm.
Cheers.
Cheers.
You sure I can't talk you into hanging on to this pickle for maybe some future time?
I'm positive. I think we have too many friends right here.
Well, none will be wasted. They must have given us about 10 pounds of the wretched things. But you know what?
What?
I think I'll do the pigeons of the city a big favor and throw the stuff in the bin. I haven't mentioned this before, but I felt really bad about not being able to get more information out of the bureau at Prisco.
Well, you did what you could. You and Sean both.
Yeah, but I felt bad about it. Always one. You two really matter to me. And I don't want to sound like old Father Time here, but I sort of feel responsible for you kids.
Robert, we're grown up.
Oh, well, just humor me. I know some things that you don't know. Sean, Anna, and I all do. But we should have taken a much stronger position about this WSB business.
You tried to talk him out of it. You told him how tough it would be.
Yeah, the one thing I didn't lean on hard enough, I guess to protect our own poor judgment at the time, was how utterly wrong it is for a married man to go into the bureau. Matter of fact, I frankly think that it should be a dischargeable matter within the WSB.
Well, they just drive couples underground.
Well, likely so, I guess.
You're just feeling rotten and responsible because I've been so nasty to you after I received that letter.
Oh, can't blame you for that.
And then there's the other side of the story. Frisco's doing whatever he's doing, not just for love of adventure, because he could do that race car driving.
Not quite. I've done a bit of that, and believe me, it doesn't really stack up when you compare it to WSB adventure.
Maybe he is after that ultimate high, that danger. I don't know, but whatever it is, he's doing it for himself.
Well, he is responsible for himself, yeah.
Well, he's also doing it because he thinks it's important and he's with the good guys and it makes him feel like a patriot.
Hmm.
It's too bad that his patriotism is costing his wife dearly.
It's okay now, though, because I know he's alive and I know he's going to come home to me.
That's the attitude.
It's a strange town I've gotten myself into here in Port Charles. I've been thinking about that, and it's getting stranger and stranger.
How come?
Well, nothing is ever as it seems here. It's like we're all trying to play this undercover game about hiding our emotions and our loneliness. I mean, take Duke, for example. We're all worried about him, but we're worried about Anna just as much as we are about him.
I guess I haven't covered up my feelings too well in that department. I've been too busy out lambasting to his face, and Anna, too, for that matter. I guess that's not very nice.
Well, he's acting very peculiar anyway. It's as if something's changed about him since Anna's been kidnapped. I don't know.
Well, I just hope we're all wrong and that he's just simply preoccupied with business.
I hope he's gotten home by now.
Well, I'm not about to call. I don't want my head handed to me again.
Maybe I could call.
Well, let's look at it this way. There's the good news and there's the bad news. The good news is that if he's home, you might disturb a delicate moment between the two of them. If he's not home, more than likely, Anna is on the ceiling.
Well, then I should call, I think.
I think not. However, you're your own person.
I'd still be there.
With a wonderful story of where he's been and why.
With a wonderful true story.
Say that again. Well, you ready to...
Yeah, I'm cold now.
You are? You ready now? You're cold?
You want some hot chocolate?
That sounds good.
Okay.
Where do you live?
Look at you, you're so beautiful.
When did you get home? I didn't hear you coming. I always wake up when you come in. Why didn't you wake me?
I got in just a couple of minutes ago. I didn't want to wake you. I've had one hell of a day. I just got a late flight back from New York.
Well, yes, I'm glad. We've got a lot to talk about.
But you can see on my face?
What?
The good news?
What good news? I don't have any good news.
Oh, come on. You're not going to chew me out because I've got a later flight than planned, are you?
No. What were you doing in New York? Angel didn't even know where you were.
Well, I couldn't tell Angel for the same reasons I couldn't tell you. It was such a half-baked deal, but now that it's finally come through. I mean, they can print it in the newspapers. I'm just so happy.
Go on.
You gonna listen?
Yeah.
Our troubles are finally over. I mean, every life has troubles, but... our financial troubles are finally over.
Did you win the lottery?
No, I didn't win the lottery, but I earned it. Now, you know, I was having money troubles at the club before you got kidnapped, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now I've got the chance to make it bigger and better than ever. You know, I told you I had this friend who had a restaurant in New York and it was running in trouble.
Yeah?
Well, he'd give me a half share in the restaurant. Now, we'll get international backing, which means we don't need bankers or anything. We can refurbish the place. We're going to turn it into the biggest, best new club in the whole of New York City.
Well, dude, I mean, if you're losing money with one club, how can you afford two?
No, you... Well, all it takes is tighter, tougher management. We just keep an eye on the trends and things very, very carefully. I mean, you know what they say in this country?
What do they say?
Well, if you haven't made it in New York, you just haven't made it. And now I can make it bigger and better than ever. I mean, our future is secure. We're financially secure.
Well, what if I say I don't want you to do this?
Well, it's a bit late for that.
I see. So you only care about what I think when I agree?
No, but just wait till you see it. I mean, you are gonna... I'll tell you that it's here. You're gonna love it. I want to play burglars again. Sneaking in on lovely ladies in my dresses.
We can't solve our problems by kissing.
No, you're right. It's going to take more than that.